Focus. There we go, focus. Hi guys, and welcome to today's video. Today is gonna be my February reading vlog. So it is currently the 3rd of Feb, and so far this month I have started reading a book, obviously. It's a non-fiction book, if I can get into it. It's called Influence by Sarah McCorquodale. And it's basically all about influencers and influencer marketing. If you didn't know, I graduated, I guess, last year now, in 2020. And since then, I've been working in search engine marketing. And I just love marketing in general and love learning. So I'm reading this book as part of the Girls in Marketing thing. So far, I've read chapter one and I'm finding it really interesting. Only like 25 past 8 in the morning, I start work at 9, so I'm gonna see if I can get chapter 2 done, maybe even a bit of chapter 3 done now. This, I think, so far is the only like non-fiction book I'm planning on reading this month. Next up, in terms of fiction, I wanna read Circe, which my friend Ella got me for my birthday in January, so that's gonna be my next read after I finish this. Hopefully this doesn't take too long. My Kindle tells me that most people only take 4.5 hours to read it, so it should be a short book. So I'm gonna go and do some reading and I will catch you in a bit. Also, I have these pretty flowers that my friend Clara got me for my birthday background, which is nice. And then cards. This card has dogs on it. My boyfriend got it for me. I like dogs, like all animals. I don't have an animal currently, but I really want a dog. But yeah, okay, you didn't need to know that. So it's now Sunday and I finished reading Influence yesterday. It was so good. I feel like I learned a lot about like influencers and influencer marketing and basically just like social marketing as well. But I'm going to move on to a novel now. I'm going to read Circe, which Ella gave me for my birthday a couple weeks ago. I've heard so many good things about this, so I'm really excited, and also the cover is so pretty. I'm going to get started on that this morning. Good morning. So it is Tuesday and I have started reading Circe at the weekend, and I just read about like, I don't know, maybe like another chapter and a half before work. I'm up to page 54 now. It's definitely not the kind of book I normally read. It's kind of like fictionalized about gods, but I'm really enjoying it so far. My hair is a mess. Yeah, I'm really enjoying it so far and I'm like that way through. I feel like it's gonna be a relatively quick read. Also, I finished my paint by numbers, which you can't see. Yep, I finished my paint by numbers, so I'm happy with that. I think I'm gonna put it on the wall at my dad's house. Hey guys, so it is Wednesday the 10th now, and it is 20 past 8, and I'm going to read some more of Circe. So yesterday I read a little bit more, about that much. Essentially what happened is Circe, who's our main character, kind of discovered her ability to do witchcraft with plants. She turned this other goddess into like a monster so that she wouldn't marry the guy that Circe liked, essentially. And her father just banished her to an island, and we've just arrived at the island, and that is where I'm up to. So I'm kind of like partway through a chapter because I was reading it on my lunch break yesterday, and then obviously like I need to finish my lunch break. So I'm gonna see how much more of this I can get read in the next kind of, I don't know, 40 minutes before work-ish. Also, I'm gonna show you one of my birthday presents from my boyfriend. Is this little llama, and he's like clay, and you fill him with water, and then I had to put like cress seeds on the outside of him. And I did this yesterday. And I'm basically waiting to see if the cress sprouts, which it hasn't so far. I've just refilled him with water because he got a little bit dry. I feel like ideally he wouldn't be above a radiator, but I said to put him somewhere that's light, and this is the lightest window in the house. Also, you can see on the table outside we have a teensy bit of snow. It like snowed for the whole of the day yesterday, but it was, oh god, that's really zoomed in. Oh no, other way. Yeah, it snowed for like the whole of the day yesterday, but it was like light snow, so it didn't really settle. Yeah, I think we're getting more snow later in the week, so we shall see. But I'm gonna get on with reading and I will see you in a bit. Eyes out of the sun. So it is Thursday morning now and it's 8:30. So I have about 20 minutes to read. I got this far yesterday. I read a few more chapters last night, not too many, so I'm up to chapter, tell you what chapter I'm up to, but I can't read Roman numerals, so I'm going to show you instead. I'm up to this chapter, so I think that may be 10, possibly. I'm not too sure on Roman numerals, so let me know. But yeah, I'm going to read a bit more for work. I'm still really enjoying it. We've just got to the bit where Circe has been summoned by her sister for her sister's childbirth, and she's had to take on Skylar. So we're going to find out why her sister has summoned her. That's where I'm up to, basically. So it's Saturday now, so I'm going to see how much of this I can get done this weekend. Hi guys, so it is now Sunday. Excuse my white hair, I've just had a shower, but I am currently... But yesterday I finished reading Circe, which is down here, because I'm about to take a picture for my bookstagram, which the link is in the description of this video. But I didn't think I was going to finish it yesterday, but ended up having enough time to finish it, and I loved it. It was so good, and it's definitely not a book like that I'd normally read. It was about Greek gods and stuff, which I don't normally read about, but I really, really enjoyed it. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. It was basically after one of the goddesses called Circe, and kind of her journey and then her son's journey, and kind of like, I don't know if falling in love is the correct term, but basically her journey. I really, really enjoyed it. I definitely recommend it. Even if you don't normally read about like Greek gods and goddesses, I really enjoyed it. And then last night, just before I went to bed, I started reading this, which is Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep, which my boyfriend got me for my birthday because it's on my book poster, which I go on about all the time. I just read chapter one. I have a feeling that I've read the first chapter before. It seemed really familiar, or maybe I read it when I opened it up the first time when he gave it to me. I don't know, but it's kind of a short book, so I'm hoping I'll get through this one quickly. But yeah, that is where I'm up to. I don't know if I'll read any of this today because I've got 210 things to do. But yeah, that's where the next reading is at. Hey guys, so it's now Monday morning and I've got ready a bit slower this morning, so I won't be reading any more of this morning. But I did read not even a whole chapter because I ended up having to help Mum with some stuff. But I read a little bit more last night, so we're now up to... here. It is quite a short book, so I don't think this is going to take me very long once I get into it. So yeah, I'm hoping that won't take the whole week, and then I can move on to, I've got another book that I plan on reading in February too. I did, however, yesterday, start listening to an audiobook because I've had it since, what is my hair doing this morning? I've had it since the end of January and I hadn't started listening to it yet, and that book is, I got quite a way through it yesterday, so I'm hoping I'll be able to finish it over the course of the next couple of days. The book is Two Can Keep a Secret by Karen McManus, and I've read her other books before. I think this was the only one I haven't read. Sorry, I should pause it. I'm really enjoying it so far. It follows basically two different characters. Ellery, I believe is her name, and what's the other boy's name? Ellery and Malcolm, and Ellery and her brother have just moved in with their gran in Echo Ridge, and their aunt Sarah went missing when she was a teenager, like pretty soon after their mum had been like homecoming queen, and this is a town where basically people have died, so like homecoming queens have died, and everyone suspects Malcolm's older brother for one of them, and he claims he's innocent and like he hasn't been arrested or anything, there's no evidence. But they're just about to do homecoming court, and all of the girls who've been nominated are getting like creepy messages and like, yeah, just weird. I'm really enjoying it so far. I'm on chapter 14. Pretty sure I'm over halfway through. The annoying thing is when I am on, oh my god, this hurts my arm holding this up. When I'm on my audiobook app from the library, if it hasn't downloaded the next section, it only has like up to where's downloaded in terms of chapters. And I'm on part 4, so it needs to download 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Maybe I'm not halfway through then. But yeah, so I don't know how long the book is. But I got through it pretty quickly yesterday. I think I've said this before, but I listen to audiobooks on 1.5 times speed because I'm impatient and like to get things done quickly. But I shall be listening to more of that. I might listen to that for 10 minutes before I start work this morning. But yeah, I'll see you in the next clip. So I'm not entirely sure when the last time I spoke to you was. But I finished reading Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep. It's quite a short book. It didn't take me too many hours to finish. I really enjoyed it. It was a bit different to my normal reading. My boyfriend got it for me for my birthday. And actually, thinking about it, I can scratch it off my book poster, which I'm going to go and get. My bed is currently covered in books because it's been a filming morning for me. I filmed 4 videos so far and I'm about to film a 5th, which is going to be organising my bookshelf. So you'll see that very, very, very soon. But yeah, I finished reading that. I'm going to scratch it off my book poster in a minute. And I've started reading British by Afu Hirsch. I've had this for a little while. It's about growing up in Britain, about her experience of growing up in Britain black. So I'm really looking forward to this because I really enjoyed Rennie Edo Lodge's Why I'm Not Talking to White People About Race. And I bought this at the same time. So I'm looking forward to reading it and learning some more because I learned so much from Rennie's book, and I know I'm gonna learn loads from this too. Anyway, I'm gonna scratch off the poster, which you'll see in a second. Okay, so I've found it and it's here. So I've gone and got a 2p piece. And see what's underneath. Little android robot. Cute. How cute. What other books are there on here? Okay. I don't know what book I want to read next off here. I really want to read 1984, but I haven't managed to get my hands on a copy from the library yet. And I'm trying not to buy books. I'm definitely going to read this. I watched the Swedish version the other day. By accident, we didn't realise there were 2 versions, but the Swedish version was really good. We watched it with subtitles. Would definitely recommend. I definitely want to read that book now. I've heard such good things about Norwegian Wood recently. I think I saw it on someone's booktube channel, can't remember who. Ulysses I've read some of at uni, but I haven't read the whole thing, but I did enjoy some of it. Anna Karenina I've got downloaded because it's free. Huck Finn, I was speaking about this in a video that I filmed today. I've basically read it, but I've never read it front to back, but I've read basically every extract, so I think I have read it, but I want to read it start to finish to be able to say that I've read it properly. Lord of the Rings is definitely going to be one of those ones that waits till last because you have to read all 3 to scratch it off. I have one of Richard Dawkins' other books, The God Delusion. I didn't ever finish reading it, but I read some of it. I definitely want to read some Sherlock Holmes, so definitely that one at some point. Obviously, I'm going to get to all of them. It's just about what order I want to get into them from. Dracula I feel like I've read quite a bit of, but never the whole thing. I really, really want to read Anne Frank's diary. Just, again, haven't got it from the library yet. What else is there? Moby Dick's about a whale, and I hate reading stuff about animals, so I'm not sure I'll read that anytime soon. I just feel like the animal will die in it. But anyway, this is how I'm getting on now. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Done 28. So we're about 5 books away from being a third of the way through. Hey guys, so it is Monday and it is lunchtime, Monday the 22nd, and I read a bit of this yesterday. I started the, not really the first chapter, but the introduction, so I'm like this much the way through. I had other things to do during my lunch break, which is almost finished, so I haven't read any more, but I'm hoping I'll be able to read some more maybe this evening. So far, I'm really enjoying it. It was just kind of an introduction as to who the author is and kind of why she was writing the book and her background and yeah, just what inspired her to write the book really. So I'm excited to get into it. I can see birds in my garden. I'm excited to get into it and see what I can learn from it. So yeah, we're about that much of the way through. I think it's a relatively big book. There's over 300 pages, so I'm thinking this will probably take me the rest of February. I'm also listening to a book on my phone. Let me find the name of it. I can't even remember the name of it. I can picture the cover. I feel like everyone's raved about it and read it. It's called Once Upon a River by Diane Setterfield. It's like this one here. And honestly, I'm not really enjoying it. I keep disengaging from it and being like, I've been listening to this for a certain amount of time and I can't remember anything that's happened, and my camera is going red and I'm not sure why. Good morning. It is now Monday, March the 1st, which means I'm wrapping up my February reading vlog here. I'm gonna insert a clip of me talking through all the books I read in Feb, so kind of like my wrap up in like 2 seconds. But I didn't get to the end of this. I'm about halfway through. Some books I find I can read quite quickly. So YA I can read quite quickly because there's not necessarily anything to learn in it. So I can just kind of like bash through it. But books like this one, there's so much knowledge in it that I don't already know that it takes me a while because I like to process everything that I'm reading. And I think that's why I thought I was a slow reader for a really long time, because the kind of books you read at school and for uni are ones that take a while to process, whereas if it's just like basic English and quite a simple story, I can bash through. But yeah, I'm enjoying it, I'm learning a lot, and in 2 seconds you will see me telling you about the other books I read this month. Okay, this is a bit of a weird angle, but I kind of wanted to sit down and I'm trying to like aim it in the right place. I currently sat on a mattress. I realised that I started finishing this vlog off yesterday. It's now Tuesday and it's the 2nd. If you're not like an OG subscriber, like if you haven't been around for a while, you might not know that I have chronic illness called cyclic vomiting syndrome, which thankfully is controlled by medication. But yesterday I felt so ill partway through the day, so I didn't do any more reading. I just kind of crashed. But I'm feeling a lot better today, so I thought I would do the wrap up of this and tell you everything I read in February, because I'm feeling a lot better today. if it's something you're interested in, I know some people subscribe because of the one video I've done on my chronic illness, but yeah, fun times. Let's go through the books that I read in February. I didn't read as many in Feb as I did in January. I don't know whether it's just because it's a shorter month or because I finished the month on this one, which I haven't finished yet, and because it's non-fiction, it's taking me a while to get through. I'm just getting up my spreadsheet on my phone. Okay, so the first book I read in February was Influence by Sarah McCorquodale. I think that's how you say her name. It was basically a book on influencer marketing and kind of the rise of influencer marketing and the differences between them, and it highlighted some key influencers and social platforms. I work in marketing, so obviously I'm interested in like anything to do with marketing, so that was kind of another non-fiction read for February. I'd recommend it if you are interested in influencer marketing. It was really easy to read and I really enjoyed it. The next book I read was the 5th one in the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy series, and that was Mostly Harmless by Douglas Adams. And yeah, that was the final one. I gave it a 3.5 star rating. They're definitely like not my normal type of books, but my boyfriend got it for me for my birthday last year, so I was trying to finish it off before my birthday this year, but obviously my birthday's in January, so I did run over a little bit, but I got it done at the beginning of February. Then the next book I read, I realized I haven't brought any of these books physically downstairs to show you because I'm just filming this in my lunch break before I start filming my March reading vlog. But the next book I read was my favorite one for the month, and that was Circe by Madeline Miller, which follows the story of Circe, who is a goddess. She's the daughter of like the sun god, and she basically learns her witch powers, and it's all about her being exiled and kind of her journey through like love and life and loss and challenges. And I'd really, really recommend it. I absolutely loved it. And then the final book I read was another one that my boyfriend got me for my birthday this year, and I'm happy to say that I read it within a month of being given it, and that is Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep by Philip K. Dick. And I rated that, I haven't rated that, I think I'd rate it 4 stars. It just wasn't what I was expecting at all, because I'm aware that it's the book that the film Blade Runner set on, which I haven't seen. But obviously I've seen like the movie poster and I was expecting it to be really futuristic, which it is, but I wasn't expecting like most of the humans to be gone from the planet. Sorry, spoilers. I guess it's not a spoiler because it's kind of in it immediately. Yeah, I'm really interested to see and watch the film now, because in my head when I'm reading books I make a cinematic production, if that makes sense, like I see everything in my head. And what I saw in my head when I was reading it would not make a good film. So I'm intrigued to see how that goes. So I guess we'll probably watch that film. We ended up not watching a film like the past weekend because we were really close to finishing Mr. Robot, the TV series on Amazon, which we have now finished and is really good, I would recommend. But yeah, that's everything that I read in February. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please let me know. And please do subscribe as well. Currently I'm seeing that only 5% of my viewers are subscribed, so if you watch me frequently and are not subscribed, there's a nice red button somewhere down here that says subscribe, and that would be good if you could click it. But yeah, I'll see you in my next video.